So right here, as you can see, I'm holding my red-tailed green rat snake female, and oh my gosh, she is just absolutely stunning. She's still, as you can see, a little bit timid. She's doing a little bit of an S stance right now, but right now I'm giving you guys a quick update on her progress, as well as some tips with snake handling. So what do you say? Let's get to it. My name is Nick Pulaski. Ever since I was young, I've had two passions, wildlife and filmmaking. My goal is to combine those two passions to make wildlife content. My passion for wildlife and my collection of exotic species is constantly growing. Come follow along as I pursue my goals of educating, inspiring, exploring, and conserving wildlife, all while having fun, seeing the beauty of our natural world. Okay, so as I explained, we have to clean the red-tailed green rat snakes today. The only way to do that is obviously to take them out so we can do a full bedding change and sanitize the cages and everything like that. So I have the GoPro ready again. So if you saw my past video of me handling the female, I did this exact same setup before where I put the GoPro right next to the snake hook and we're gonna take her out and then we're going to handle her a bit more. I mean, like I said, I've been handling her a lot more lately. She's definitely calmed down a lot more. She's still a little bit timid, but I mean, it just takes time sometimes with certain snakes. Sometimes right off the bat, they're going to be totally okay. Sometimes it takes a little bit more time. So that's kind of where she's landing right now, just taking a little bit longer just to calm down and get to know me a little bit more. And I'm not trying to like take her out constantly and handle her. And I understand that maybe that's just her personality, where maybe she's just a little bit timid by nature. And we're just going to respect that. So without further ado, we have to do what we have to do and clean the cage. Let's get to it.
All right, so let's see what kind of mood she's in today. Spilled her water a bit. I'm going too much water in their enclosure just because I clean it so much. Also, they like to make a mess out of their cages. She's puffing up a bit more. Just trying to let her know that I'm here. Hey girl. Yeah, she's whipping her tail a little bit. Let's take the branch out so she can't get hurt and wrap around it. Let's take her hide out. Oh my gosh, even though she's upset right now, I mean, she is just absolutely incredible. She is such a cool animal. There we go. Whew. Look at her. Oh my gosh. She is absolutely gorgeous. I mean, just her size in general. I mean, she is definitely around, like, I'd say 5 feet. She's whipping that tail around. Oh my goodness. She's definitely getting better on the hook, I would say. You have to have trust with the animal, really. Letting them know that you're meaning no harm. Keeping, obviously, your distance if the animal's a little bit timid like this. Yeah, she's kind of getting used to me a little bit more on here. She definitely isn't fully comfortable with me yet. As you can see, that tail is just kind of whipping around right now. But there she is. She's kind of chilling right now. I love her colors. Absolutely gorgeous. She's not too much of a fan of the GoPro, you can tell. Yeah, we're just gonna get her in our holding container for a second. We're gonna clean up the cage. We will go from there. So basically, the first step of handling any snake or any animal at all, to be honest, is having confidence. You wanna make sure that you're not scaring yourself, because if you're not comfortable handling the animal, then the animal is going to be comfortable with you handling it. So having that mutual trust is definitely something that you guys wanna have. Another thing too to do before handling an animal is obviously educate yourself. Know what you're getting into, know how the animal naturally behaves. And going off what I basically said before with going in with confidence, I did want to go off a little bit more and say that you do also want to have respect for the animal. You don't want to just like handle it improperly by like grabbing it by the head or anything like that. You want to learn the proper technique of handling snakes. Otherwise, it's going to hurt the animal, and also it could hurt you. I guess for an overall thing I'm trying to say is, don't expect with an animal that it's not going to bite you or that it is always going to bite you. You just have to read the animal, respect the animal, and just kind of learn about the animal. And all you have to do, honestly, is just handle with confidence. If you're confident, then the animal is going to be confident, and then it just becomes a mutual relationship. So now that the cage is finished, what do you say? Let's get to holding her and see what kind of mood she's in. All right, so here she is. As you can see, she is kind of missing a couple scales right on her nose. She actually came to me like that when I got her. It's nothing that's going to harm her or anything like that. There's no infection. She's had it basically her whole life. I absolutely love these snakes. They have such a look to them that's just absolutely amazing to me. Still kind of nervous, but we're just kind of chilling with her. Like I said, I mean, this is what I did the last time. I just let her do her own thing. Just kind of let her know that I mean her no harm. And she's kind of knowing that now. So as I've said in the past, there's no such thing as an aggressive snake. There's two kinds of snakes. There's either
there a defensive and timid snake, which is what she's doing right now. As you can see, she's in that S stance, still not used to being handled. Still working with her, like I've said, but it just takes time. And another reason a snake would lunge out at something would be for food reasons, which she does have a really good feeding response. She's always taken for me. She's never not accepted for me. Isn't she gorgeous? I'm petting her softly right now. But yeah, just petting her right now. Totally calm. Slow little movements, not doing too much. Just letting her get used to me. This is what I've been doing, honestly. Just kind of slow little movements like this. Not trying to do too much, not trying to scare. This also builds your confidence up too with the animal, which is huge. You want to do that. She still doesn't have a name. We need to get a name for her. So if you guys had any name suggestions, let me know down in the comments down below. And I mean, you see, she's not even trying to go for my hand. She can definitely see it out of the corner of her eye. She's realizing. She's not whipping her tail around like she was at the beginning. But yeah, I just wanted to update you guys on her and her progress. For now, thank you guys so much for watching the video. If you guys could do me a couple favors, her as well. And let me know down in the comments what you think her name should be. As well as if you could like this video and subscribe to my channel, I would greatly appreciate it. And until next time, I will see you guys soon.